Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Welcome to the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. Today is Palm Sunday of the Passion of the Lord. We shall now begin our celebration. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. Hosanna in the highest.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent, we have been preparing to welcome the Lord into Jerusalem, where he is to fulfill his mission in the Passion, Death, and Resurrection. Today, as we all open this solemn, most solemn week in our faith and in our church, we gather together as one church to recall the triumphant entry of the Lord into Jerusalem, the city of destiny, where he is to fulfill his passion, death, and resurrection. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we ask you to sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ the King in exaltation may enter Jerusalem through him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus and the disciples drew near Jerusalem and came to Bethphage of the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village opposite you, and immediately you will find an ass tethered and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them here to me. If anyone should say anything to you, reply, 'The master has need of them.' Then he will send them at once. This happened so that what had been spoken through the prophet might be fulfilled. Say to daughter Zion, 'Behold, your king comes to you, meek and riding on an ass and on a colt, the foal of a beast of burden.' The disciples went and did as Jesus had ordered them. They brought the ass and the colt and laid their cloaks over them, and he sat upon them. The very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, while others cut branches from the trees and strewed them on the road. The crowds preceding him and those following kept crying out and saying, 'Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.' And when he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was shaken and asked, 'Who is this?' And the crowds replied, 'This is Jesus the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee.'" My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who was an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross. Graciously grant that you may heed this lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
My God, why have you abandoned me?
All who see me scoff at me. They mock me with parted lips. They wag their heads. He relied on the Lord. Let him deliver. Let him rescue him if he loves him.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
Indeed, many dogs surround me. A pack of evildoers closes in upon me. They have pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
They divide my garments among them, and for my vesture they cast lots. But you, O Lord, be not far from me. O my help, hasten to aid me.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
I will proclaim your name to my brethren. In the midst of the assembly I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him. All you descendants of Jacob, give glory to him. Revere him, all you descendants of Israel.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Verse before the gospel, Christ became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every other name. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Jesus stood before the governor, Pontius Pilate, who questioned him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus said, "You say so." And when he was accused by the chief priests and elders, he made no answer. Then Pilate said to him, "Do you not hear how many things they are testifying against you?" But he did not answer him one word. So the governor was greatly amazed. Now on the occasion of the feast, the governor was accustomed to release to the crowd one prisoner whom they wished. And at that time, they had a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when they had assembled, Pilate said to them, "Which one do you want me to release to you, Barabbas or Jesus called Christ?" For he knew it was out of envy that they had handed him over. While he was still seated on the bench, his wife sent him a message. "Have nothing to do with that righteous man. I suffered much in a dream today because of him." The chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowds to ask Barabbas, but to destroy Jesus. The governor said to them in reply, "Which of the two do you want me to release to you?" They answered, "Barabbas." Pilate said to them, "Then what shall I do with Jesus called Christ?" They all said, "Let him be crucified." But he said, "Why? "What evil has he done?" They only shouted the louder, "Let him be crucified." When Pilate saw that he was not succeeding at all, but that a riot was breaking out instead, he took water and washed his hands in the sight of the crowd, saying, "I am innocent of this man's blood. Look to it yourselves." And the whole people said in reply, "His blood be upon us and upon our children." Then he released Barabbas to them, but after he had Jesus scourged, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus inside the praetorium and gathered the whole cohort around him. They stripped him of his clothes and threw a scarlet military cloak about him. Weaving a crown of thorns, they placed it on his head and a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews." They spat upon him and took the reed and kept striking him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of his cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him off to crucify him. As they were going out, they met a Cyrenian named Simon. This man they pressed into service to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means place of the skull, they gave Jesus wine to drink mixed with gall. But when he had tasted it, he refused to drink. After they had crucified him, they divided his garments by casting lots, and they sat down and kept watching over there. And they placed over his head the written charge against him: "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Two revolutionaries were crucified with him, one on his right and the other on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying, "You will destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days. Save yourself if you are the Son of God, and come down from the cross." Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes and elders mocked him and said, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. So he is the King of Israel. Let him come down from the cross now, and we will believe in him. He trusted in God, let him deliver him now if he wants him. For he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" The revolutionaries who were crucified with him also kept abusing him in the same way. From noon onward, darkness came over the whole land until 3 PM. And about 3:00, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Some of the bystanders who heard it said, "This one is calling for Elijah." Immediately, one of them ran to get a sponge. He soaked it in wine and, putting it on a reed, gave it to him to drink. But the rest said, "Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to save him." But Jesus cried out again in a loud voice and gave up his spirit. And behold, the veil of the sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. The earthquake, rocks were split, tombs were opened, and the bodies of many saints who had fallen asleep were raised. And by coming forth from their tombs after his resurrection, they entered the holy city and appeared to many. The centurion and the men with him who were keeping watch over Jesus feared greatly when they saw the earthquake and all that was happening, and they said, "Truly, this was the Son of God." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we begin the solemn observance of the Holy Week. And for the last 40 days, we were preparing for this Holy Week. And today we call this celebration the Palm Sunday of the Lord's Passion. And I think I would like to invite you now to reflect on the Passion of our Lord. But this time I'd like you to reflect on it as we begin our Holy Week. I'd like you to reflect on it from a different perspective. The theologian Father Hans Kung said that for people to live a meaningful life and a life of purpose, he said, you need to give them three things. Number one, you give them something to live on. Number two, you give them something to live for. And then number three, and perhaps the most important, is you give them something to die for. And I think if we reflect on the life of the Lord, these three things are very well summarized in what we celebrate this coming week. According to all evidence, Jesus, during his hidden life, lived as the son of the carpenter, that he himself engaged in the trade of being a carpenter. Jesus, son of Joseph, the carpenter. So for almost 30 years of his life, from the time that he grew up and was able to work, he certainly had something to live on. He had his own trade, so to speak. And at the age of 30, we begin to see now the second part of his life, something to live for. And at the age of 30, he begins his public ministry. And we know that the beginning of the public ministry is narrated in the baptism of the Lord, wherein now Jesus goes to John the Baptist and remember that beatific vision as he begins his public ministry. This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. That was something that the Lord heard at the age of 30 when he began his work, his ministry as a rabbi, as a teacher. He knew that he was the beloved Son in whom the Father is well pleased. And so begins that part of his life, something to live for. And for 3 years, the Lord lived out that meaning of his life. He lived out his mission to proclaim God's kingdom. He lived out his mission to proclaim the salvation that comes through the kingdom of God. And today we begin to celebrate and to remember the third part of his life, something to die for. As we heard in the readings for this Sunday, that beautiful prophecy from Isaiah, the song of the suffering servant, when you have that beautiful line that says, and his face was set like flint towards Jerusalem, which prophesied the determination of Christ to enter Jerusalem, the city of destiny, wherein he knew he was to fulfill his mission to suffer and to die on the cross and to be raised up in the resurrection. Now begins his third part, something to die for. And today, as we begin the celebration of Holy Week, we remember the Lord's suffering. And yet it was for this that he came for. In the second reading for this Sunday, the beautiful ancient hymn that we read from the letter of Paul to the Philippians, that he emptied himself, took on the likeness of men, that he may offer himself for us. And today, as we begin the celebration and the remembering of the passion, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, let us remember that this is what he came for, that he was here to have something to live on, something to live for, and now comes the most important part of his life, something to die for. And I invite you during this Holy Week to reflect on these three gifts of a meaningful life, to reflect on your own life, to reflect on what God has given you as something to live on, and to be grateful for this, and to reflect also on what it is that you are living for, what is the meaning and purpose of your life, and perhaps to ask for the grace that during these moments of quiet, these moments of prayer, what is it that we are willing to die for? And today, to all our Kapamilyas in ABS-CBN, we remember Ron in this way. Ron was someone who not only gave himself something to live on, but made sure that all of us, no, the people that he worked with, Ron was always concerned that people had something to live on. And even as we approach this moment of this lockdown, Ron was also busy preparing for that. Together with his entire team, he made sure that we had something to live on. And of course, now also we have the memories of Ron about something to live for. I remember when we were preparing for our hearings in the Senate, Ron was very diligently preparing for that. Ron was ready to defend ABS-CBN. Ron was ready to show that all the accusations against our network, all of these are not true. Because for Ron, ABS was something to live for. And of course, we will remember that one of the greatest joys of Ron is Lovely and their daughter. In fact, every time you mention that to Ron, it will put a smile on his face. And today we pray that his daughter will always remember him. His daughter will always remember him as the father who dedicated his life for her. And Lovely, we also are with you. In this very difficult moment of not even being able to be withdrawn, we pray that you may be accompanied by our Blessed Mother and by our Lord. And today we honor Ron, who dedicated his life to his family, who dedicated his life to ABS-CBN, and to the many, many people that he had worked with. They have very, very fond and affectionate memories of Ron. We thank the Lord for knowing Ron. We thank the Lord for Ron being a part of our lives. We will certainly miss him, but now as we enter the season of Holy Week, we renew our faith in the resurrection. And we pray that, especially for Lovely and the entire family of Ron, we pray that your faith in the resurrection may deepen once more. My dear brothers and sisters, as we enter the season of Holy Week, let us remember our Lord. Let us remember that everything that will happen this week, His suffering, His death, is so that we may share in His resurrection. Let us continue our celebration as we enter this great season of Holy Week. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
In this time of the Lord's Passion, when Christ offered His very life for our salvation, let us turn to Him now and offer our prayers and supplications. Let us ask the Lord to be with us during this special moment of Holy Week amidst this crisis that we are going through. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may be more fully cleansed by His blood in this time of His Passion, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through the blood of Christ's cross, all things in the world may be brought to peace for the sake of salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that all problems around the world, especially the spread of COVID-19, may be finally contained and authorities may be able to find a solution for its cure, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may grant fortitude and patience to all, especially those afflicted with COVID-19, and to our frontliners who, through sickness or hardship, have a share in Christ's passion, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may all be led through the Lord's passion and cross to the glory of His resurrection, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now, in the silence of our hearts, offer our prayers and petitions to the Lord. We pray specially for the eternal repose of the soul of Ron, that the Lord may welcome him into his presence. We pray for Lovely and their entire family, that the Lord may be specially present to them and console them. So for a few moments, let us remember our prayers. Let us remember specially Ron, Lovely, and their entire family. Lord Jesus, as we begin the celebration of the commemoration of your passion, death, and resurrection, we ask you to cleanse our hearts and our minds that we may be worthy to share in these mysteries through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness, we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Through the passion of your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, He suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and His resurrection has purchased our justification. And so with all the angels in joyful celebration, we too acclaim, Holy, Holy,
Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop. Remember your servant, our brother Ron, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially the victims of this pandemic. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has claimed lives and has affected many. We pray for your grace for the people tasked with studying the nature and cause of this virus and its disease and of stemming the tide of its transmission. Guide the hands and minds of medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion, and of those government and private agencies that must find cure and solution to this pandemic. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Grant us the grace to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus, and may Mary, our Blessed Mother, place over us her mantle of protection. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Mary, help of all Christians,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
And I'd like to invite all of you, all of our Kapamilyas joining us today to offer this prayer for Ron. Eternal rest grant upon your servant Ron, O Lord.
And let the perpetual light shine upon him.
May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Soul of Christ, sanctify Ron. Body of Christ, save him. Blood of Christ, inebriate him. Water from the side of Christ, wash him. Passion of Christ, strengthen him. O good Jesus, hear him. Now that at the hour of his death, he has joined you together with your blessed mother and all the saints, we ask you to welcome him into your presence, to embrace him with your eternal love. And Ron, we ask you to pray for us, especially in the midst of this pain of losing you and in the midst of this crisis. Please be with us, pray for us, and continue to offer your life and your prayers for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And let us pray. Nourish with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Look, we pray, O Lord, on us, your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ did not hesitate to be delivered into the hands of the wicked and submit to the agony of the cross. Grant us, O Lord, to join your Son, our Lord, in his passion, death, so that we may share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go and celebrate the Paschal mystery.
Thanks be to God.